Baldwin, this is a shout out to Torrid Magazine.
Thing that's been good to me.
On the border of each other. They're right on the coast. Really beautiful, a lot of space, quiet. Kittery's like 5,000 people, maybe. Portsmouth's about like almost 30. Everyone is, you know, really friendly and very inclusive environment and supportive. I was 18. Yeah, I was like a senior in high school. It was definitely my choice. Music was always like in my dad's a musician, so music was always around, and I was always more into sports and stuff growing up, and my parents were really supportive. They didn't like push me to play music. They just they were into me playing sports and stuff. So then I just kind of got into it on my own, you know. I lived in Middletown, Connecticut, which is a small, like, college, like, Wesleyan University is there. I lived there right after I went to college. I went to college in Hartford. It was really influential to be around Anthony Braxton, who's like a jazz musician and like kind of new music composer and stuff. So that was like those were very like formative years. And although I'm sort of doing different things now, that was like in a way some of the most like the busiest and sort of like the hardest I ever worked, just on my instrument, and just sort of like the most focused I've ever been in a way. So those were really important and influential years. As far as like influences sort of more directly with my music, it's sort of hard to say, because I like so much different music, and there's lots of things that are inspiring to me, anything that I like, but whenever I write music, I want it to just, I never think about other music or think about trying to sound like something, or, I just feel like the best way it can be presented is just like this honest sort of like just coming from you. So I never know how to answer that exactly, like the influence thing. I feel like I'm just sort of influenced by everything or nothing, or I don't know. Examining sort of past experiences and how that's shaped, you know, who you are now, where you're going in the future and stuff. So that's sort of like the title, People Changes, just like how people change and like evolve and develop over the years. Most of it is sort of like more like autobiographical and stuff that has happened to me in the past. And I don't know, I've been into writing songs that aren't autobiographical lately, like I'm just, but still writing them in first person, like so that I have a personal connection to them. But so I'm excited about recording some new songs, I guess. Oh wow, yeah, I prefer day. Coffee. The Incredible Hulk, is he a superhero?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. The Baxter. This is like a Peter Brotzmann. He's like a free jazz, crazy German saxophone man. He's got an album called Machine Gun, and it was sort of a seminal album for like free jazz, like European free jazz in the 60s. I just thought it would be a weird, crazy thing to get, and my mom does not like it. And this is Charles Mingus. He was born in the state of Arizona, so his, it's just a print, you know, spaced outline in the state, and that's a little bass thing. One like a basketball thing on my leg, but we'll save that. Being away from home a lot, although I do really like touring a lot. There are times when, like right now, I wish I could spend more time at home. I just moved into a new place, so I'm sort of just settling in and really psyched about it. So yeah, it's sort of it's tough to like leave when at that. It's a weird time to be gone. And I right before this tour, I was in Europe for about 3 weeks, so and I have a lot of stuff going on, so it's, I'm not gonna be home that much, so that's a hard thing. Goodbye.